Welcome to 2K Sports for another edition of NBA Basketball. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and our sideline reporter is David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, we all know Ja Morant's a high flyer. He says, "My dad was pretty athletic when he played, so I can say some of it comes from him. Jumping on tires and the other drills, they just allowed my legs to get stronger. It's enabled me to get off the floor quicker, be more explosive, and it shows when I'm out there on the court." Kevin, it certainly does.
He is a high flyer indeed. David, thank you. Look at the opening lineup for the Memphis Grizzlies. The wingmen are Bane and Brooks. Adams is the pivot for him with Jackson Jr. at the four. And it's Morant in a point guard. And for the Lakers, LeBron James is out there with Thomas Bryant. Then it's Patrick Beverley. Then there's Dennis Schroeder. And it's Brown in at the small forward. This contest has the potential, Clark, to be very exciting. Two teams that can really run up and down the floor and run up the scoreboard.
Yeah, you know, if one of these teams gets really rolling, Kevin, they might be able to take advantage of this one, but I agree with you. When you talk about these teams, I'm anticipating and even hoping for tons of lead changes.
Brooks misses. Brown with it. Now, here's Beverley. Beverley sets the screen for Schroeder. Off target with his three. Enzo Brooks will bring it up for the Memphis Grizzlies. Morant looking around. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
In terms of entertainment factor, can any current player top Ja Morant? I mean, we've seen Ja with some vicious in-game throwdown.
It's his first trip to the line. The first free throw is good. Hey, Greg, talking about the great Ja Morant, this guy is just flat out fun to watch.
Well, Ja's been known to go off for 50 on any given night, but he also looks for others, dropping some nasty dimes. Morant has an insane combination of athleticism and skill. This guy can do anything.
Stolen by Brooks. And about a minute gone here in the first quarter. Morant outside. Back to Brooks. Score of the basket. Nice shot after missing his first attempt.
A point who knows his role. Ja loves setting guys up, always looking to pass it.
Here's Schroeder, and Adams sends it back. Bane with it, picked up by Bryant. Bane passes to Morant. Draws contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
The rugged toughness of Morant. Excellent at fighting through there and capitalizing in style.
He's made one and missed one so far in the game. Good from Morant. Well, Greg, with this Memphis Grizzlies team, you like how young and how hungry they are. It's very appealing.
And these players have bought into the system. This is a selfless group that knows each other's strengths, and it's why they've seen so much success here of late.
You know, once he takes that first step, LeBron is virtually unstoppable. Raw athleticism gives him the upper hand.
At the elbow, it's Jackson. Back to Morant, and Morant throws it down.
It puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, GA. He really does put pressure on you.
And you know, guys, showing how dynamic a weapon he is for this offense, they feed off of that energy and ability to make plays. It gets them going.
James, no good.
And even without that three ball dropping for him, the defense should have done more on that last play.
Pass to Adams. Shot from the low block. Back to Bain. Adams with the screen on Bryant. And Adams with the slam.
God, he threw that one down. Adams, one of the fiercest competitors in the league.
Lakers trail by 8. LeBron outside. Pass to Schroeder. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw coming up.
Yeah, outstanding job there of taking the harm and still able to finish.
Yeah, he imposed his will on the defense that time. He was not going to be denied right there.
Good from Schroeder.
And when you think about veteran guard Dennis Schroeder, still such a shifty, unpredictable player.
Yeah, he really is, because of the way he can change gears and play at different speeds. Very impressive. At his best, when he's putting blinding speed to use, he doesn't always unleash it, but when he does, it's very effective.
And so it's Schroeder with the ball. He'll bring it up for Los Angeles, trailing by 5. This, of course, their first opportunity to play Memphis this season.
In this game, just the first of 4 meetings between these two. They'll get quite familiar with each other by season's end.
You know what, guys? I don't know. I get the feeling that this could be an interesting matchup this season. This first game will tell us a lot.
Bane with the bucket.
And this is something Morant does well. His knack for knowing when to make that feed is impressive.
Here's James. He's as potent an offensive player as you're going to find in this league. He averages almost 30 points a game. Bryant with a screen on Jackson. Knocks it loose. Morant with the steal. And it's Brooks in the corner from outside the arc. And again, it's Memphis with the 3. And a chance now to catch up on some numbers here. The hustle stats for the Grizzlies.
Well, you know, they've been aggressive on the defensive end, and it's paying off for them. Quite a few takeaways for them in the early going.
And they're making their own luck with how hard they're playing, forcing turnovers and turning that into offense.
And the Lakers decide to take their first timeout here. And we've got a lineup change for the Lakers. Let's check out the Western Conference standings right now that we're here in the new year. You look at the Grizzlies. They're holding on to 2nd spot in the conference. A great season for them so far. And, of course, Los Angeles. They have a lot of ground to make up.
And, guys, when you look at Memphis, they had a few critics coming into the season, and now I don't think they have any. This is a club ready to not only make a deep run, but possibly win it all.
They do have the pieces in place for a title run, but the competition in the playoffs will be stiff.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
One of my favorite eras in NBA history, Clark, the 80s Showtime Lakers.
Man, I played against those guys. Thankfully, it was just twice a year because we were in the Eastern Conference. But those dudes were unbelievable. Magic running the point. Kareem still playing at a high level down low. Worthy finding his stride and finishing the break. They didn't just win titles. Showtime had a flavor that was fun to watch if you weren't being run out of the building by them.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Westbrook with a wide open look. A three-pointer, no good. And the Grizzlies leading by 9. There's 47 seconds left in the first. No good from Clark. For Los Angeles, they've gotten 3 of 8 shots to fall for them here in the first quarter. Nunn kicks to Westbrook. Nunn with the screen for Westbrook. And the pass to Christie. Back to Westbrook. 6 to shoot. Los Angeles needs to get off a shot here. Nunn can't get it to fall. And here are the Grizzlies. They're on a 16-7 run. Clark sets a screen for Jones. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
Excellent all-around performance so far, hence the big lead.
Yeah, you know, they've had the advantage at both ends. They've got all the momentum early on.
Here's Westbrook. We saw him with 19 points his last outing. Here's the screen. And the last second attempt does not go in for him. And so it's Memphis. Up by a dozen here at the end of the quarter. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. We come back right after this. And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And guys, the Grizzlies enjoying a nice lead here.
They came in on a mission, razor-sharp offense in that first period.
Yeah, I agree. That was a flawless offensive performance so far. I mean, the shots have been falling. They're making good decisions. That's a nice recipe there.
With just about a half season behind us, the rankings are clearer than ever, Greg. Do you feel confident starting to make some playoff predictions?
Oh, Kevin, it's way too early for that. Injuries, other roster shakeups. There's just still so much that could happen and totally reshape those rankings.
Patrick Beverley out there with Dennis Schroeder. Then it's LeBron James. Then there's Brown. And it's Bryant in at the 5. That's the Laker 5. Lakers trail by 12. Out to the right wing. Fires the 3, and the rebound goes to the Grizzlies. And here's Morant. He's got 6. Outside, Bane. Good, and the nice assist from Morant. Morant's got 4 assists in the game.
And really, it's been a major aspect of their offense in the early stages here. Their success working the ball inside and getting points from close range.
Now, here's Beverley. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. His first shot coming late. Los Angeles with another miss.
Boy, great effort on defense there against a guy who typically makes that.
Here's Morant. It doesn't go for him. And the Lakers take it the other way. James outside. Pass to Schroeder. Back to James. Fader on the way. And the shot is long.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that.
Payne for three. And the rejection by James. Here's Adams. On the wing, Brooks. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Morant. Let's pause for a moment to show you the teams that have been the best on the glass over the course of the month. Number one, the Grizzlies.
I mean, they've taken their rebounding to another level, getting physical and playing with a ton of energy.
And we're about 2 minutes into the second quarter here. And it's Schroeder with the ball. He brings it up for the Los Angeles Lakers. Nothing offensively yet from them in the second quarter. Here's LeBron. And the rejection by Jackson. And a wide open look for Bane. And another miss by Memphis. Lakers trail by 14.
And the defense of Jared Jackson Jr., it has become elite. Triple J finishing top five in 2022 in the Defensive Player of the Year voting.
Now, here's Bane. After the miss from Dennis Schroeder. It's Morant in the corner. No good on the three.
Well, you know, they're in the lead, but he's still been frustrated from an offensive standpoint.
James, and the rejection by Jackson. Beverly against Brooks. There's Jackson with the three. Memphis the rebound. Adams the pass to Bain. No good with the triple.
Well, I admire the fact he's trying to power through this rough stretch, but on occasion, you'll have periods like this.
James against Adams. There's a screen by Bryant. Trying to end the drought, and the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line. Greg, why do you think Jaren Jackson Jr. made that leap defensively in his game?
Kevin, health. Jackson was finally back to 100% in 2022. The ability to kind of fully use his physical tools, and Jaren's still learning from playing night in and night out, now living up to that massive potential.
Looking at who's out there now for the Lakers. Gabriel's checked in. Toscano Anderson comes in for Troy Brown. Kendrick Nunn, he's checked in for Patrick Beverley. And Russell Westbrook is subbed in for Dennis Schroeder. Memphis leading by 11. And a little under 3.5 minutes elapsed in the second quarter of play. Brooks dishes to Adams. Outside for Jackson. Cranes it from beyond the arc. Jackson's got the lead up to 14 now for Memphis.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Let's check in with our reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks very much. The Lakers are, of course, one of the league's storied franchises. And Magic Johnson was asked recently if they have the best all-time collection of players. He says, it's not even close. Outside of Bill, we have all the dominant closers. Kobe, Jerry, LeBron now, Worthy. Come on now, it's just too many Lakers. Kevin, back to you.
Well, he's got a point, David, and we thank you for your report. Christy, he's checked in for Bryant. Right, here's a classic NBA question. Who's been the best franchise in league history? Celtics or the Lakers?
Come on, Kevin. You are putting me on the spot. But I'd go with the Lakers. More superstars over the years. And I think that 2000s run with Kobe and company, that put them ahead in my estimation.
Now here's Jones following the miss by Russell Westbrook. Williams sets a screen for Jackson. And they recover it. Here's Conshaw. A new 14 for the Grizzlies. And it's good for two. and the Grizzlies lead by 19.
As the game has gone along, they've gotten more and more aggressive on the backboard.
Well, it's paid off with a greater rate of second chance hoops. I mean, great effort to build this lead on their part.
Here's Gabriel, still looking for his first bucket in this one. Clock at six. Pass to Toscano-Anderson. And again, no good by the Lakers.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Passes it to Conshaw. The pass to Jackson. It's in. That's his third field goal of the game. He's 3 for 5.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Here's Westbrook. He's been a factor in their offense on most nights with his scoring average at nearly 16 points a game.
Watch the screen.
Pass to Gabriel. Here's Christie. To the wing on the left. 5 to shoot. Can they get it? Here's Gabriel. 2 free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. The Lakers have had 2 chances at the line already, making them both.
And typically a strength of theirs, 79% on the season.
And guys, I'd have to credit the work they put in at the free throw line to practice this season. I mean, because they have noticeably improved since a year ago.
First one falls for him. The Grizzlies making a switch here. And good on the second, so he makes them both. From deep 3-point range, and the last shot before the buzzer is off.
Well, excellent job that time by Westbrook to challenge without fouling.
It's been all about Jaren Jackson for the Grizzlies. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. And we'll be back with you shortly.
Greetings, everybody. We love exciting. And this game is delivered, as we've seen 2 top players battling mano a mano.
A couple of guys locking horns tonight. Neither one of them backing down, as you would expect. You could tell both teams are giving these guys space to work.
And they're taking advantage of the opportunities. Now let's talk about our game tonight. A nightmare of a first half for the Los Angeles Lakers.
And they were gutting a little too much from downtown. They can't afford to become dependent on that shot. They got to compete the consistent way. I like to see them mix it up more in the second half.
And that concludes halftime. Now time to send it over to Kevin Harlan as the game's about to resume.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. You look at Jaren Jackson, what a contribution.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of him.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. And so it's Schroeder with the ball. He'll bring it up for Los Angeles. 19-point game. Kicking off the second half, here's Taylor Jenkins' 5. In at the guard spots, Morant and Bain. At the forward spots, it's Brooks and Jackson Jr. And it's Adams in at the center, filling out the middle. Clark, when they're evaluating draft prospects, we always hear about wingspan, arm span. How does that translate to the basketball floor?
Well, it's actually reach factor, Kevin. That's a huge component of defense, particularly when you're talking about guys switching all the time. So the ability to cover ground, to challenge shots from a distance, that's why wingspan is so important. And you think about it, multiple defensive player of the year, Rudy Gobert, perhaps has the longest wingspan ever recorded at the combine.
No good on the second free throw.
Boy, the shifty, quick-footed Schroeder is a great weapon to have. Whether he's starting or coming off the bench, he's a very effective player.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
Here's LeBron following the score by Dylan Brooks. Bryant passes to Schroeder. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Taking matters into his own hands.
Yeah, we didn't expect to see that kind of finish.
And you know, guys, when your point guard is making explosive plays at the rim, I really do think it sets the tone for the rest of the team.
And so here's Memphis after the basket by Los Angeles. Adams with the screen on Beverly. Here's Bain, banked in off the glass. Baines got 7 points in the game.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness. If they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
During Desmond Bane's first season, Greg, he shot over 43% from three-point territory.
And that was top 10 all time for a rookie. And Bane's three-point numbers went up in his second season. From the start of his career, Desmond's been a premier shooter.
And out of bounds as the Grizzlies gain possession. And the Grizzlies leading by 20. Right around a minute and a half played here in the third quarter. And it's Morant missing.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
Schroeder passes to Beverly. LeBron outside. There's the screen. Back to Beverly. The three ball. That one doesn't go.
Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
Bane looking around. Here's Morant. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. He's got 8.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's 4 straight field goals now they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
And that one's good. Schroeder.
Schroeder has worked to become a proficient shooter off the catch. You know, that was not a strength of his coming into the league.
Brooks against Brown. Nice shot by Brooks.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
Lakers trail by 21. James outside. Brown inside. Brooks covering. And it's Brown that time on the assist by James.
Really doesn't matter what position LeBron is playing. The point, the 4 or the 5, James changes games with his passing ability.
And that was another look at the fantastic Mobile One drive that happened a moment ago.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow.
Now here's Brooks. 9 points in the game so far. Pass to Bane. And the 3 off target. Los Angeles has gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Beverly with a screen on Jackson. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Ja Morant. That's his 3rd foul of the game. And the Lakers with some changes. Christie's checked in for Troy Brown. Kendrick Nunn comes in for Patrick Beverly. And Russell Westbrook is subbed in for Dennis Schroeder. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. And here's James outside. And the 3 ball is good. James has got 5 points so far.
Really nice looking stroke on James's shot from out at the arc. He can make the 3-point shot look so easy, just like he does every other part of the game.
Now, here's Bane. 7 points in the game. Clark. The shot will not fall. Nice D from Bryant. Lakers trail by 16. Nunn looking around. Bryant with a screen for Nunn. Driving to the basket. He can't get that one to fall. And so it's Payne who brings up the ball for the Memphis Grizzlies. 22 is their biggest lead. And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. We've heard about player tracking on the court, but now shot tracking is helping players refine their strokes. It measures not just makes or misses, but the arc and the depth and the left to right direction of shots. These systems provide instant feedback to shooters and help them find the bottom of the net. Kevin, back to you.
Sign me up. That is a fascinating story. David, thank you. Shot clock at 5. Kristen. It's rebounded by Memphis. There's 1:17 left in the third quarter of the game. Clark outside. Kicks to Morant. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. They get Russell Westbrook.
Boy, Morant's brought a lot of excitement. He almost always makes the night's highlight reel. He is what I'd call an elite showman.
And a moment now to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from here for the Grizzlies.
You love how they've lived in the paint, making the defense just consistently have to collapse and still finding ways to convert.
The other thing they've done is they have not shied away from the mid-range game. I mean, plenty of points coming their way off of jump shot opportunities. I like that.
Here's what the Lakers are going with right now. Gabriel's checked in, and Toscano Anderson subbed in for James. Jones checked in for the Grizzlies. And he misses the second one as well, so he is 0 for 2 that time. Passes it to Nunn. Outside Westbrook. Driving the lane. Here's Toscano Anderson. That shot off. And Memphis the other way now. Morant outside. That one goes in. Morant's got 10 points.
And that speaks to Morant's fearlessness. Even amongst the trees, he is confident, looking to score with the ball.
Lakers trail by 20. Westbrook scanning the floor. The pass to Nunn. Some solid defense from Clark. For Memphis, they've gone 6-9 from the floor here in the second half. They've got to be happy with that. Here's Morant, and finished off by Morant.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
And don't leave out the coaching staff here now. I mean, their game plan has been perfect.
Westbrook fires away from outside. Los Angeles with another miss. And so it's Memphis, holding a 22-point lead as the quarter wraps up. Their defense has been very effective in locking down Russell Westbrook. We've got more in store for you right after this. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm Assist of the Game.
Yeah, an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for him.
Served him up a tasty room service dime right there, boy.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. LeBron James is out there with Troy Brown. Then there's Dennis Schroeder. Then it's Patrick Beverley. And it's Gabriel in at the five down low. That's the Laker five. And it's LeBron James with the rebound. James has got 6 rebounds here tonight. He dishes it to Brown. And we've seen not only some new trophies in Bruce, but Greg, Some of the existing ones have been updated. You okay with that?
Oh, I am. In particular, a nice touch to have the previous winners etched into the base of the Larry O'Brien Trophy. That's a great way to connect with the history of the game.
Here's Brooks, following the basket by LeBron James. Pass to Aldama. They set the pick. Outside, Jackson takes the three. Lakers with the rebound. Schroeder, left side. James in the post. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder.
A monster down low. LeBron James, the rare package of skill, size, and athleticism.
Pass to Aldama. Shot clock at six. Back to Jones. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. And the Grizzlies lead by 20. Just over a minute and a half played here in the fourth. Jones against Schroeder. There's a screen. No one near James as he lets it go. Off target from outside. Jones, the pass to Jackson.
And between his footwork and height, Jackson is a tough matchup for defenders. Here he takes full advantage and draws the foul.
That's good from Jackson. And the play-in tournament, Greg, is here to stay, but the terminology is somewhat in limbo. Is that going to be part of the playoffs?
You hear people say it's not the playoffs, it's the play-in. Maybe the term postseason should cover both the play-in and the playoff. Something to think about.
And so Jackson nails both of them. Game moves along. 2 minutes gone here in the fourth. Now Schroeder passes to Brown. To the paint, James. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. Man, is it easy to remain in awe of the greatness of LeBron James. Clark, this is a guy that just doesn't seem to age. It's amazing.
Yeah, it's really one of the remarkable runs in the history of sports in my mind, quite honestly, Kevin, on and off the floor. We know he spends a lot of time and money to keep his body in peak shape. He yet is still not showing any real signs of slowing down. We know Father Time is undefeated, but I tell you what, LeBron is giving it a run for its money.
And both free throws good for LeBron. Hard to believe, Greg, last season, LeBron missing the playoffs for just the third time in his career.
And Kevin, it almost felt surreal to not have him in the playoffs. I mean, this guy's been a fixture in the postseason for almost two decades now. Just another bullet on LeBron's incredible resume.
And another miss by Memphis. Lakers trail by 20. For those just joining us, fourth quarter here, we're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard.
No, sir. Jackson Jr.'s shot blocking abilities, part of why he was a top five pick back in 18.
Takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down.
And how about the hands on Jackson? Makes a good target on that frame and then able to finish off the alley-oop.
James finds Schroeder. Well, as we know, it's here to stay, but people continue to voice their opinion on the play-in tournament format. Where do you fall?
I like it, Kevin. I really do. It's creative. It's innovative. It adds a level of excitement, that do-or-die feel that you sometimes don't get unless it's a Game 7 in the NBA playoffs. I really think it's a good add-on.
And you like to see this from Brooks, right? No need to fall in love with the jump shot. Give the defense different looks.
Timeout called, the Lakers. And we're about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter. James looking it over. And with the internet and social media, players Clark have so much more ability to engage with the public and be heard. Is that important?
Kevin, anytime you can empower folks to share their voice, their stories, and be authentic in their own way, I think that's a positive. Player empowerment is something that social media avails, not only to players, but I think to everybody. It doesn't just bring attention to the game, but also causes and commitments players have to their respective communities and issues that are going on in the world. So I think it can be far more good than bad when you think about the platform of social media.
And right now, let's watch that terrific swat.
Such great timing, defensive awareness too. When you have to face a defender that can reject you like this, it certainly can change your approach.
And Los Angeles will go for a different look here. Gabriel's checked in. Toscano Anderson comes in for Troy Brown. Christie's checked in for Patrick Beverley. And it's Kendrick Nunn in for Dennis Schroeder. Then for the Grizzlies, Brandon Clark, he's checked in for Adams. Williams comes in for Dylan Brooks. And Conchar subbed in for Bane. 1:46 left in the fourth quarter. And there's the pass to Nunn. Out to the right wing. And he tries off the glass, but it's no good. And it's Jones with the ball for the Grizzlies. Outside Jackson. Pass to Williams. The dish to Jones. Over Nunn. Jones, no luck. The Lakers shooting around 24%. Not a good showing here.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for Memphis.
A beautiful pass doesn't always get you on the highlight reels, but there were some spectacular dishes in this game.
You know what? It was a team that was in sync and just trusted one another to take the right shots.
And so checking out their record tonight, that'll mark win number 32 overall.
And asserting themselves up front here, guys. They'll be taking the front end of a four-game season series between these two. They've got to feel good about getting the upper hand tonight against the Lakers.
And as usual, some excellent work tonight in what was a quality big-impact game for Jaren Jackson.
Well, the defense just couldn't figure him out, and he continued to put it to him.
And so Nunn nails both of them. Here's Jones.
Who's got tires?
54 seconds left in the fourth quarter. That shot misses. Here's Toscano Anderson. To the inside. Here's Bryant. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. And he makes the first. Bryant hits them both. 34 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Clark outside. To the middle. Deflects the pass. Just five on the clock. Clark a screen on Christie. Jones, no one around him. Connects from three-point range.
And they came in determined to take this one. It's going to be a happy flight home.
Yep, to have a stress-free win on the road, very satisfying. The fans are already headed for the exits.
So no problem for Memphis as they get the win. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much, Ja. A lot of swag on this team tonight. Who's responsible for that confidence?
I feel like we all talk to each other, even the coaching staff. Coach let us play with a lot of freedom. Everybody have the green light. So, I mean, there's no reason to lack confidence when you have a coach who believes in you every step of the way and just let you go out there and play your game. So we always just preach, you know, keep shooting, make or miss, and we're behind you. So
you all look like a confident bunch, man. Congrats on the win. Back to you.
David, thank you as always. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. As we present our New Balance Player of the Game, Jaren Jackson.